Hey guys, what's up? मैं हूँ आपका दोस्त और होस्ट श्रेयस. Welcome to the Hair Career Mentors. We build happy careers. So today we are going to talk about the top 10 career options to pursue after UPSC exams.
Apart from IAS, IPS and IFS.
इस वीडियो को देखने के बाद आपको UPSC exams clear करने के बाद कौन-कौन से career options हैं इसकी पूरी जानकारी इसमें मिल जाएगी और बहुत कुछ सीखने को भी मिलेगा. So before we begin, if you wish to seek a holistic guidance and planning and do wonders for the rest of your life, then contact us now at the number shown below or visit our website which is www.dhaya.com. तो चलिए वीडियो को स्टार्ट करते हैं, लेकिन उससे पहले चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूले और बाजू में जो बेल आइकन है उसको भी दबाना ना भूले. हेयर करियर मेंटर्स बाकी सोशल मीडिया चैनल्स पे भी है, जैसे फेसबुक, लिंक्डइन, ट्विटर और इंस्टाग्राम. उन सब की लिंक्स भी डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में है, आप जाकर देख लीजिएगा और लाइक और फॉलो कीजिएगा. अगर आपका लास्ट एपिसोड देखना रह गया हो तो उसे आप एक तो यहां पर भी देख सकते हैं, नहीं तो उसकी भी लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में है, आप जाकर देख लीजिएगा. तो चलिए गाइस, फाइनली विदाउट फर्दर एडू वीडियो को स्टार्ट करते हैं. बहुत मजा आने वाला है आपको, एंड तक हमारे साथ बने रहिए. लेट्स गो.
नंबर 10, Railway Protection Force. The Railway Protection Force, which is RPF, ensures the security of passengers and the properties of the Indian Railways. Some of the duties include to uphold the integrity and safeguard the interests of variable elements of railway properties that are inclusive of all units and entities under it. Offer remedial measures that improve the welfare and well-being of all railway properties. Facilitate easy access and approach to the usage of railway properties. To identify vulnerable areas and trespassing chances of railway entities and take measures to avoid such situations. Number 9. Indian Postal Service, that is IPOS. The Ministry of Communication and Information Technology has created the Department of Posts to facilitate postal communication access through a wide network of post offices in India. Indian Postal Service officers deal with the management and administration of postal services across the country in the specific postal hub that they are assigned to. Number 8. Indian Communication Finance Service. The duties of ICFS are assessment and collection of license fee and spectrum usage charges paid by telecom licensors, spectrum auction, policy making in Department of Telecommunications and Department of Posts, financial management of Department of Posts and Department of Telecommunications, internal audit of Department of Telecommunications and Department of Posts, counting of Department of Posts and Department of Telecommunications, pension management of DOT, DOP, BSNL and MTNL, human resource development and capacity building of IP and TAFS Group A, among others. Number 7. Indian Ordnance Factory Service. Indian Ordnance Factory Service officers are gazetted, that is Group A, defense civilian officers under the Ministry of Defense. They are responsible for the management of the Indian Ordnance Factories, which provide the defense production capabilities of India. Along with taking care of defense supplies, the Ordnance Factories also work into the logistics part, buying raw materials, product design, implementation, testing, servicing, marketing, and research and development units, among others. Number 6. Indian Information Service, that is IIS. Indian Information Service is the media wing or section of the Government of India. They act as the bridge or link of communication between the Government of India and the people, communicating various government policies and schemes to people and also collecting valuable feedback for policy formulation are some of the main responsibilities of an IIS officer. Number 5. Indian Defence Estate Service. The induction training for Indian Defence Estate Service is held at National Institute of Defence Estates Management, located at New Delhi. Probationers are initially posted as Chief Executive Officers in cantonments. The post involves carrying out executive functions of civic administration and land management. The post also carries an appointment house, suitable transport and other infrastructural support for discharge of executive duties. Number 4. Indian Defence Account Service, that is IDAS. The Indian Defence Account Service is one of the Group A services of Government of India. It is a service which is responsible for accounting functions of the Defence Department. The Defence Accounts Department, DAD, is headed by the Comptroller General of Defence Accounts. The Indian Defence Accounts is an important department which provides financial payment and accounting and internal audit functions of Army, Navy, Air Force, Ordnance Factories, Border Road Organizations, Defense Research and Canteen Stores Departments, among others. Number 3. Indian Corporate Law Service, the ICLS, is a specialized and combined service that unifies the knowledge of all three streams, Chartered Accountancy, Legal Studies, and Civil Services. The main point of responsibility is attached to the Companies Act Administration together with the Liability Partnership Act and a few other co-related acts. Number 2. The Indian Civil Accounts Service. Indian Civil Accounts Organization performs a key role in delivery of financial management services for the Government of India. The organization provides payment services, supports the tax collection system, performs government-wide accounting, financial reporting functions, preparation of budget estimates, and carries out internal audit in civil ministries of the Union Government. Number 1. Indian Audit and Accounts Service, that is IA and AS. The civil servants under the Indian Audit and Accounts Service serve in an audit managerial capacity in the Indian Audit and Accounts Department. IA and AS is responsible for auditing the accounts of the union and state governments and public sector organizations and for maintaining the accounts of state governments.
So guys, ये थे सारे career options जो कि UPSC और बाकी competitive exams से भी related है. I'm sure you liked the video और आपने बहुत कुछ सीखा होगा आज यहाँ से. अगर आपने जरूर सीखा है तो इस video को like, comment और share करना ना भूले. Once again, if you wish to seek a holistic planning and guidance and do wonders for the rest of your life, then contact us now at the number shown below. Or visit our website, which is www.thea.com. Thank you very much for tuning in today. अभी हम मिलते हैं अगले वेडनेसडे जहां पर आपके लिए हम ऐसा ही एक शानदार और इन्फॉर्मेटिव वीडियो लेके आएंगे. So, उसके लिए बने रहिए. उस वीडियो की नोटिफिकेशन पाने के लिए चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूले और बाजू में जो बेल आइकन है उसे भी दबाए. हमारे बाकी सोशल मीडिया चैनल्स भी है, फेसबुक, लिंक्डइन, ट्विटर और इंस्टाग्राम पे. उस पर भी आप जाइए और उनको भी लाइक एंड फॉलो कीजिए. उन सब की लिंक्स डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में डली हुई है. और यदि आपका लास्ट एपिसोड देखना रह गया हो या चूक गया हो तो वापस जाइए और जरूर उस एपिसोड को एक तो यहां पर, नहीं तो उसकी लिंक भी डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में डली हुई है, वहां पर जाकर देखिए. हैव फन एंड कीप लर्निंग.